We're here with James, the chief water operator for the village of Sherman. That was one of the first installations in the U.S. for the OverWatch. You know, just installed back in January 2018.
We were going down here to declog these pumps every week, every 2 weeks, more often left off. It just depends on our flow, obviously. So we are constantly with a confined space issue with this, obviously. And this is our bread and butter right here of everything coming in from the village itself. So we would have to go down and rake that bar screen weekly. Two guys, confined space. So you're looking at, we were down there for at least probably anywhere from a half hour to an hour, depending on how bad the flows were for that week. And usually at least quarterly, probably we would have to have a vac truck come in and clean that wet well out because of the mop rags and the grease would, I mean, it would get anywhere from 2 to 3 feet on top of that down there. We have a birdcage sensor in there, which actually caused problems also because that would get in that grease layer and it would actually show no flow. So then it would shut the pumps off. So that well would actually fill up and cause a lot of problems also. With the new system, you know, that sensor being inside the pipe like that, it doesn't collect all that grease, all that grit, all that stuff you don't want in there. Confined space was the biggest thing. Like, you go from weekly to, like I said before, I mean, I haven't been down there in 4 years. My other guy's been down there once. That's a huge. When you don't go down there for once every 4 years, I mean, that's huge. And we were in there for 20 minutes. We pulled one pump just to check some things out. One guy for 20 minutes and he was in, out, and done. Where before we would rake that bar screen for, you know, half hour, pulling buckets out of here of stuff. We don't do any of that stuff anymore. So like I said, I've since 2018, I've never been down in here. And yeah, it's a no-brainer at that point.
Any visits from the back truck?
None. We would do that at least quarterly, if not more often. Haven't had to call them since, so that was a money-saving thing more than anything with that. I mean, that I think up to anywhere from $300 to $600 every time they showed up, depending on how much they took out of here. And that was a whole day process too, because we had to be down there for that too. And I did that with our guys. I didn't want to. They don't have any manpower to do that, so we would actually be down there for hours. I mean, we'd come out, go back down, come out, go back down. That was a huge, huge savings there.
Any clogs or anything?
Nope,
like that?
No clogs. Since installation in 2018, I mean, this has been, it saved so much time, saved so much money, effort. I mean, just some of the guys that we've had work here don't like confined space issues, period. They don't like the depth. So that's, it's been huge. We used to keep track of the pumps, which one was on, one or two over there. We don't even do that anymore because I, in all honesty, forget the things here. I mean, yeah. It's just, it works and we know it's working. Before we would worry at night if the pumps were running. Now I don't even think about it. I honestly don't think about it. We come in the morning and we look at the board and it's flowing and we know it is. I would do this every single time if I had to go back in time and do and make that decision for sure.